All right, let's turn this mother out. This is Face the Music, a Jeff Lynne's Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast. Episode 193, Help Yourself.
I thought I could turn things around and show you something that was new. But all I got was disappointment. I was left without a clue. But you can never change. You just keep on being you. You got to help yourself. Help yourself. You got to help yourself. Help yourself. You got to help yourself.
What's that song all about?
Help Yourself is the second track on From Out of Nowhere. In the November 10th, 2019 issue of online magazine Louder, Jeff Lynne said,
I tried to make it a bit of a soul-type number. It's actually one of my favorites because I like the chords in it. There's a little bit of three-part harmony in there, which I like. I like it very much, and I know you're not really supposed to say that about your own stuff. It's simple, and yet there are quite a lot of chords in it. There's some really nice chords in there.
On the December 16th, 2019 episode of All Songs Considered, Jeff said,
he's still working on it, you know, like, to teach you to think better thoughts. Well, I think what I'm saying is, really, you've got to help yourself. You know, if nobody else will help you, you've got to help yourself. And that can mean lots of different things, which I won't bring up because you'll think that that's what I mean.
Right.
But it means in every kind of field, if you want to get it done, you've got to do it yourself, really. Help yourself. Which isn't a negative thing at all. It's actually like a kick up the trousers.
I just wanted to help. I don't need your help.
Hi, I'm Eric Winsenson.
And I'm Eric Paul Johnson.
We are going to engage in some self-help.
Not me and you. I got a wife.
No, self-help is different than what you thought I was going to say there.
Okay, let's keep it that way.
Self-help is a way of getting through things and staying psychiatrically normal, I guess, or psychologically normal, or not getting stabby.
Well, again, it's sort of the same thing, so.
One of the things you can do to help yourself is to meditate in a peaceful environment, listening to music that'll put you in a relaxed state. A very, very relaxed state. Because that music is so repetitive. Actually, it is a repetitive song. We're still not going back to the big excitement of Electric Light Orchestra. But even though I'm getting a little snarky about it, I didn't mind this song. It's got some keyboard parts in there and some whizzits, even though it's Jeff playing the whole thing. But he adds a few little touches here and there. Adds the double, triple, quadruple track vocals he does that used to be a big hallmark of the older E.L.O. It's not as good as the opener, but at this point I wouldn't abandon the album if I was listening to it. It's like, okay, this is a decent song. Still better than most of what was on Alone in the Universe. It's livelier. That's the one thing I can say, is that it's showing some life. It might still be stuck back in that old 90s sound, but at least it's showing a little bit of life.
Andrew Kelly, back a few months when he said he didn't like the podcast after only listening to two episodes, and then apologized for slamming us after only two episodes, so he's a nice guy. He said, okay, I'll give it another chance, but we'll see what you guys say about Help Yourself. This could be the podcast that makes it or breaks it with Andrew Kelly. The opening lyrics to this make me wonder if Jeff has been listening to the podcast, at least covering the last two most recent Electric Light Orchestra albums. I thought I could turn things around and show you something that was new, but all I got was disappointment. Yeah, I can kind of understand that from my end, too. But as for the song, instead of just dwelling on the lyrics, which, by the way, I am going to dwell on the lyrics while we're here. Jeff gets knocked, and I think rightfully so, for his half-assed lyric writing. And I think even he will admit that he's all about the music, and then he thinks, oh, lyrics. I gotta put some words in this thing. I love you under the moon, during the summer in the June. I hope you like my little tune. All right, we're done here.
Gotta get some words up in this bitch.
That's right. But this one, I really love the lyrics here. They come across as pretty snarky. If this is about a person that he knows, I don't know. But I can't really tell. Only Jeff could say. But it really seems like it's like somebody he's worked with in the past who didn't come through, or just it didn't work out, and he tried, and it was just, okay, well, this isn't working. It's over. I'm done here. I'm going to go help myself. Which, lyrically, yeah, I am stone cold 100% behind this song. I feel this, because he said that it's not so much about telling somebody, go help yourself. It's sort of the generic yourself, everybody, you, as if it's me. Hey, Eric, go help yourself, is what I would say in my brain to myself. And it explains why Jeff does what he does. Basically, sometimes you can't really depend on other people, though things will fall through with other people. But you're reliable to yourself. And I can totally, absolutely get behind that. I did an underground satire newspaper for, I don't know, 20, 25 years. And my co-founder was a brilliant writer. She was horrible with deadlines, though. She would tell me, I got it coming, don't worry. I'm going to write this out and get it to you tomorrow. Tomorrow would come. Don't worry. The other tomorrow. It's coming. I keep hearing that. And then eventually it's deadline time, and I got nothing. So I'm left with holes to fill, or there are a couple of times where the issue was pushed back a whole nother month. However, from that frustration, I learned, don't depend entirely on other people. Have a backup plan, or help yourself, which is pretty much what I've done. Wanted to write these humor columns? Well, I'll just start my own underground newspaper. I want to do my own comic strip? Well, I'll release that as its own publication while I'm trying to get syndicated. Music. I'll just do my own music by myself, with myself, because there's no way this stuff is going to be picked up by a record label, but I want to do it. Radio. I had no experience, so I just started doing a podcast as a radio show.
The Eric Paul Johnson Radio Troller Program.
And it was horrible at first, but helping myself, I got much better at it. This podcast, I keep looking around for years. Is there an ELO podcast yet? No, nobody's done it. And then at some point, it's like, you know what? Just do it your damn self. And even at my last job, it seemed like I was the only one who was getting certain things done. And it's something that is so welded into me that there have been times when my wife has said, you know, I can do this for you. And I was like, oh yeah, I have a wife now. She can do that while I get this done. And this way, things get done for both of us and we're both happy. Ah, I have a partner now. So, yeah, lyrically, I totally get behind it.
Sorry, my mind was going completely off track there.
Yes, I'm sure it was.
These are things I do for myself, but I've got a wife now, and she says, hey, I can help you with that.
Oh, yeah. Hey, that makes things much more easier. Ah, my life is happier now. Really happy now.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's romantic.
Okay, that one's for the expanded episode. Or the uncensored episode. Anyway.
Yes.
Getting back on track.
Mm-hmm.
It surprised me because before now, I will admit, the only two songs I'd heard had been the title track and then that one that he did for the fans.
That will come up later.
Yeah, that one he did for the fans, we did a little mini thing for, and yeah, I did not like that at all. And I think that was one of the first things that started ticking off a lot of the fans is because, oh, he did something sweet. And I'm sitting there,
when Sensen doesn't like it, he's got no sweet in him. He's just solid bitter from all that coffee he drinks.
Yes, I am. But Help Yourself is a good song. I was expecting the drop-off like we had with Alone in the Universe, where, ah, when I was a boy, and whatever that second thing was, which I'm going to have to look up so we can actually talk about that.
Yeah.
And then that, and that, and that, and that, and Ain't It a Drag is a good song, and...
No, it's not.
And then we start getting towards the end, and we get to Alone in the Universe, and yeah. But so far, it's been from Out of Nowhere. Well, yeah. As much as I wish it would sounded like some of the older stuff, it's a pretty good song, and Help Yourself is good as well. So I don't know. I'm waiting to hear the rest of this album to see if, despite the going over the old 90s sound again, that it may not matter if it still sticks to some quality lyrics and adds little things here and there to make the songs livelier. So hopefully this is a good sign. I have my fingers crossed, I have my toes crossed, I have some other things crossed, and that is causing me great, great amounts of pain. I should see a doctor about that.
Your kidneys?
And...
You might want to untwist your kidneys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping, I mean, I know there's at least one song on here I don't like, but that can be said about almost every album.
Yeah.
So in the world, so.
Musically, I like the song. It kind of reminds me of Moment in Paradise, just the way Jeff sings the lyrics. I'm not saying it's a direct copy of Moment in Paradise. I'm just saying that the way he sings it, it's sort of the same delivery as Moment in Paradise.
She never cried, she only tried to fly beyond her dreams. And as the world grows dark beneath the setting sun.
You know, I listened to the album straight through 2 times before we hit this podcast, and I didn't really notice this song too much. But now that I have to pay attention to the song, and I listened to it, I liked it. And I listened to it a whole bunch of times. And I listened to it a whole bunch of times this morning. And the more I heard it, the more I liked it. So, I like it. I actually like it a lot. It will go on a playlist. I don't know. So Far From Out of Nowhere has surprised me. I suppose you could say my like for the album, at least these 2 songs, came from Out of Nowhere.
Ugh, lousy pun.
Got something to say about Help Yourself? Then call the telephone line voicemail.
6238503375.
But you can never change. You just keep on being you. You gotta help yourself.
Help yourself.
You got to help yourself.
Help yourself.
You got to help yourself.
Here's another public service feature.
Back to the podcast.
Good, well, everybody, it's me, that Dono guy, yeah, that Xanadu thing, and here's my take on Help Yourself. However, this comes with another warning. I'm afraid I got another Arizona adjustment story related to the song, so approach with caution, or fingers in eardrums. Months after our arrival to this brutal sunshine state of the Southwest, and when it got cold enough to go outside to do anything, I went out for a walk and had From Out of Nowhere playing on my old iPod, trying to dig into the album and understand it. The highlighted track of this particular urban hike was Help Yourself. I was trying to get past the thudding drums and the technical lo-fi patterns to find some life in it, thanks to the little hints like the Moog crescendos and some fancy guitar licks. However, while I was paying attention to the lyrics, but not enough to slam into a wall, I've done enough of that in the early days of my Walkman years, some guy pulled up and started to bark something directly at me. The volume level only protected some of the words, but in quick fashion I noticed these aimed words were not pleasant, like, "Are you fucking okay? You better burn that shirt, pal, and you better do something about that." The latter phrase, which was delivered over 10 times. When the police innocently drove by, Mr. Screamer shut up and left pretty quickly. When I got home, I looked at a mirror and noticed the Pismo Beach, California t-shirt I was wearing. Yep, I just got a good dose of Arizona pride. I would bump into him a few days later when he was being arrested in front of the police station for, according to the local press, drug possession and selling to minors. So he was a tweaker and a proud state booster. Sadly, whenever I hear this song and its lyrics, I get this GOP gubernatorial candidate echoing over Jeff's vocals. No, I'm not blaming all of this on Jeff. It's just, I'm just glad I didn't move to Florida. I think.
Sun and sand, sagebrush and tumbleweed, rolling mountains and giant cactus. You and your family can enjoy the thrills of this spot. Travel this year the roads to romance, the land of your heart's desire.
This week, we help ourselves to the song of the week. Greetings, ELO fans. Mike Hudson here with a few thoughts on this week's offering, Help Yourself. I actually like this song quite a bit. It's not bad at all. One of the better tracks on From Out of Nowhere, and certainly better than the title track that preceded it. I suppose my two biggest gripes about the song are that it just sort of starts all of a sudden and similarly ends all of a sudden. I don't have anything against cold starts or cold stops in songs, as long as they sound right, but in this song it feels like it's begging for some kind of build-up at the beginning, and I'm thinking maybe at the end it may have needed one more revolution of the chorus before ending on that cold Help Yourself. This song probably wouldn't have been out of place on Roy Orbison's Mystery Girl album. There are elements in it that remind me of some of the songs on that album, especially those descending piano chords in the verses. The guitar riff in the background of the chorus reminds me of one of the songs on Zoom, but at the moment I just can't seem to pinpoint which one it is. For those missing strings in later ELO productions, there's plenty of keyboard strings on this one. Okay, they're not real strings, but at least it's some kind of strings. And there's that nice crying guitar solo sound too. And of course, Jeff's vocal harmonies are spot on. I like how in the third verse there's this arpeggiated keyboard pulsing in the background. It adds a little something new that we don't get in the first couple of verses. It's not in your face, but it's there. That's one of those little ELO whizzits that Jeff's famous for and makes this track a lot more like a classic ELO song. The lyrics aren't too bad either. I wonder what the inspiration for the song was. Perhaps the Erics will unearth this in their part of the podcast. So, with all that said, I'm going to take this opportunity to make my exit for this week. Until next time, Mike Hudson, out.
Well, hey, this is Troy, and I don't have too much to say about Help Yourself because I really don't want to repeat myself by now, but I have always liked this song since I first heard it, and I tell you why. It's got nothing to do with the music, but the lyrics. I mean, I can relate to this song. I think many of us can. We've all had that one person, maybe, that we went through a breakup with, and we're just like, oh, come on, man. Why don't you change? And yet we realize they're never going to. And I tell you something, if I had a dollar for every time a woman said to me, but you don't change, you just keep on being yourself. That's my favorite line in the song, by the way. I could probably buy a nice house, maybe a nice car. But if I had a dollar for every time a woman had said that to me, hey, I could buy my own island. I mean, can we talk here? Well, that's all I have to say for this week. Talk to you next time. This has been, as always, a Thought from Troy.
Like it, hate it, what does Madeline think?
I like the song, and the song was called Help Yourself. It did say help yourself when I don't like help yourself. Help yourself with food or help yourself. Help yourself whatever you're doing, because I'm not helping you, you crapster. That's just rude. Love you guys. Hello, amigo.
Wow, she liked it.
Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra's song-by-song podcast, is a production of Radio Trolla Entertainment, Assorted Deli Meets Amalgamated. You can contact us by voicemail at 623-850-3375 or email us at eloftmpodcast@gmail.com. Keep up to date on the show by joining our Facebook group and spread the word by sharing the link or giving us a quick rating on iTunes. You can financially support the podcast at patreon.com/ELOpod. Next week, episode 194, All My Love.
I think he's missed a trick there. I think instead of saying, "But you can never change, you just keep on being strange," which I like better than "keep on being you." But there you go. Just help yourself. It's later than you think. Oh, it's a different one. And take.